Thank you. Thank you. But I love Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In every part of his being, I love his existence. I love his mission. And I love how he holds me. Love how he keeps me.
Yes.
I'm glad that the Lord kept me.
Amen.
down, whether you're wrong or not.
Hallelujah.
Or is the Lord hearing you or not?
It's
almost like as if you're stagnant, not as only be stagnant, but standing.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
At that present time, the greatest time in the life.
Yes.
We think that we are not supposed to go through that. Amen. It's almost like as if you think you're a sinner.
Hallelujah.
You feel something.
Yes.
Well, if he don't pull back, you won't never pull forward. And if he doesn't draw back, you'll never have confidence in him who's in you.
Yes.
To rise up and walk.
Hallelujah.
We can't become babies.
Yes.
No more.
Hallelujah.
We gotta grow. We gotta learn to follow. As he leads, every single avenue we go
through. Thank you, Jesus.
So we can so dependent upon him. He leads. My leader, my this, my that. Be dependent upon Jesus.
Yes,
amen. I gotta leave your presence. But Jesus said, I'll never leave you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Glory be in your name, Lord. Hallelujah.
He said, I'll never leave you.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Neither will I forsake you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
And if we trust in him, and give him the honor that he deserves. Anything you've ever wanted will slowly come to pass. I'm telling you that Jesus is real.
Yes. Jesus.
He's here.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
To make us free.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
But you gotta want to be free.
Amen.
You gotta want it more than life itself. But you'll never be free if you don't get sick and tired of you.
Amen.
You gotta stay sick and dying. Sick of hurt. Sick of trusting in emotions. Drive me from circle to circle. And sick of trusting in these dumb, fallible emotions. I'm ready to surrender. I'm ready to give you, Lord, my whole entire life. I'm trying to hold that up to you, God. He is genuinely sweet. You love him. You'll die for him. He'll give you everything you need. He does it for me. He'll do it for you. I'm not talking about money. I'm not talking about houses. I'm talking about peace. That you can trust. Joy that you can glean from. Even in this chaotic world. Jesus said, he came to me. You won't lack nothing if you just say yes.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah.
If you say yes.
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
I need you.
Yes. Oh, hallelujah.
Just yes, Lord.
Yes.
If you didn't get the yes to that, your glory, hallelujah, it's a surrendering of the form.
Yes.
I'm tired. I'm tired. I trust. I trust you. I have nowhere else to go.
Yes.
Give you a yes, glory, hallelujah, amen.
Yes.
Amen. He brings you to the point of your knees, your spiritual knees, buckling on your backs, and surrendering, whether you're standing up or sitting down.
Yes.
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 Says you're the one.
Yes.
That's going to change my heart.
Yes.
You're the one.
Yes.
That's going to change my heart. Yeah. Today I give you my life. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. Glory be to God. And I will surrender if there's any problem in here that don't mind giving Jesus his glory, his praise, and the honor that he deserves. Stand with me.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Father, touch every soul. Thank you.
Glory! Glory!
through the old and full background. When you do that,
hallelujah,
it'll be like something fell right
off. Hallelujah.
When you do that, it's right there. It's right.
Yes.
It's right. Thank you. Good to be here in the house of the Lord. Good to be alive. Good to be alive. Thank you, Jesus. He truly is great. You know, your Sunday school lesson talked about God's covenant. Abram.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. I see the power.
But your weapons of warfare is you believing that your praise binds the devil's mind, binds his works in your life, and literally shackles any activity that had come to be a snare unto you. Because when you open up your mouth has the power of creation. What you speak, so you are. That means you have the power to create freedom by the word of God, or be bound to say, I can't. But God gave Apostle Paul a statement. And that statement is, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. So now, we are compelled to think about two different things, but only instructed to take the one. Are you hearing this? So now, what the Lord is saying is that in your mind, it's either life or death.
Jesus is on your side. How many know that the Lord is on your side? Jesus, hear me, was the contract given to us. Are you hearing this? So I just gonna be all right. Give the Lord more lives than I have enough. He just followed the candy bar. So it's hurting the chest. It should be all right. You drink a little bit of water. The covenant flesh and bone. His name is Jesus. See, the reason, oh, I want you to hear this. I want you to hear what the scripture is putting in my spirit. The reason why the devil got back off when you call on the name of Jesus, because it reminds the devil his part of the contract. When you call on the name of Jesus, the devil's reminding you he can't touch you. So the power inside of that name brings acknowledgement to the enemy that he can't touch you. No wonder why he said that demons tremble out of that name. You know what they're talking about? Because if they violate, they're done.
Yeah.
One thing that the devil don't want to go to is the outer, the pit. The outer pit, it ain't nothing. It ain't nothing. Don't throw us to outer darkness. They don't want to violate that. So, all right, I'll leave you alone. I'll leave you alone. This is the reason why the enemy don't want you to call. Because that man backs him off of you. It reminds him of this contract. You can't touch him.
Jesus!
Oh. See, you can't go to work. The Lord said, he compacted his word in the body form and put a name above every name. He shortened it to help you. Jesus. Going the other way. I heard a demon say, stop saying that name. And Jesus, 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 Jesus. They can't say it. It reminds them of their position. Don't you dare touch us. When you call on the name of Jesus, it reminds them of God's authority when that name Jesus is called. Listen to what he says now. Listen to what he says. See, the similitude of how things were to be on the natural sense, God had to come and complete it on the spiritual sense. This is the reason why the law of the Spirit is a duplicate. Hear me. Jesus said, I didn't come to do away with the law. He came to complete it. The inner man needed to be connected with the word of God. Not by our doings. This is the reason why Jesus came, to condemn sin in the flesh, that he may devour what was controlling you from the inside out.
And not be called after the order of Aaron.
He ain't gonna be called after the order of mankind, but he's called after the order. See, Joseph Smith and all them were called after the order of Aaron. Because they died. They didn't come back to life. But Jesus came after the order of Melchizedek. For when he died to kill sin. That was the part that died. But there's a part about our Lord and Savior called, his name is Christ, the Son of God, was the part and the power that still lives in today. ceremonies of the law that have no power. Are you hearing this? It was the ceremonies that they did. The blood and it is not. Go ahead and read.
For the law made nothing perfect.
For the law, here, made nothing perfect. The law. The ceremonial part of the law made nothing perfect. But check this out.
But the bringing in of a better hope did.
Jesus is that better hope. Go ahead and read.
By the which we draw nigh unto God.
We draw nigh unto God by the blood of the Lamb. Here is a priest could not even go into the holies of holies. I want you to hear me. He couldn't go to the holies of holies without blood. He had to have blood. Are you hearing me? Thank you.
My name is
them.
Yeah.
Love them. God bless you, man.
Yeah.
Look to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, I'm going to find out my new name is Ben.
Ben.
Glory, hallelujah.
is the mediator of a better covenant.
Go on ahead, the mediator. Oh, listen. When somebody mediates, they go on ahead. I know what it's saying, but let's just go ahead and do it this way. Mediator brings things to a lighter room. Between God the Father and us. To give the Father, remember how it was for me? Well, have compassion on him, Lord, because remember when I got touched with? Well, I know what it feels like, and I know what it's going to take to get them up over that hill. The written contract to the performance.
Now that which decayeth and waxeth old is ready to vanish away.
Listen, listen. Go to Hebrews 9. Go ahead and read 6.
Now when these things were thus ordained, the priest went always into the first tabernacle, accomplishing the service of God.
I want you to see this now.
But into the second went the high priest.
The high priest alone,
once every year.
That's the reason why Jesus was made a high priest. Because he's going into avenues that the normal priest can't go into. I want you to see this. Go ahead.
Not without blood.
In other words, a priest can come in this area of the sanctuary. This area of the sanctuary. Hear me. The high priest comes in this part of the sanctuary. This is the Holy of Holies. Are you hearing me? The high priest had to come out, really, but
which he offered for himself.
He offered for himself. In other words, the high priest came with blood to offer for himself first
and for the errors of the people.
And then for the sins of the people. Go ahead.
The Holy Ghost, this signifies,
yes,
that the way into the holiest of all was not yet made manifest.
Not. Why is the temple kept you. You should know that what rightfully belongs to the master. Read, look, now, don't you see this? Read.
That could not make him that did the service perfect.
In other words, you see why? Do you see why this ceremonial service could make the individual perfect? You see why this service right here could not make the individuals who did this perfect? In other words, their conscience couldn't be renewed because their conscience was still tainted with sin. Read.
As pertaining to the conscience.
But in other words, my conscience couldn't be made perfect. But I still had one because I still had sin to deal with. I didn't have no power to overcome nothing. That's what most priests are dealing with. Why they always had to come with blood. Watch this. Read.
Which stood only in meats and drinks.
The ceremony is not only, you see the ceremony that he's saying, the meats and the drinks and what?
And divers
and different types of washings and
carnal organs.
And carnal organs to do this and that, you know what I'm saying? Get the ball all the time, get up early in the morning, go set up the thing to go do the sacrifice, and the you got to cut the lamb. Take the blood and put it on a cup. It's got to be an unblemished lamb. All these different ceremonies. He got rid of
Christ, being come and high priest,
he being come a high priest
of good things to come
by what?
By a greater and more perfect tabernacle. his own blood.
But by his own blood?
He entered in once into the holy place. Having obtained eternal redemption for us. For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of a heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctified to the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God?
Are you seeing what the Lord is saying? Read that again. How much more? In other words, the blood of the bulls and goats and the ashes of the heifer sprinkling the unclean, sanctifies and purifying the flesh. In other words, you were forgiven based upon the ordinance. You were forgiven based upon the ceremony. But you were subject to go and sin again. Are you hearing this? Listen to what he's saying. You can get contaminated again. But there's a more excellent way, a new and living way. Read.
And for this cause, he is the mediator of the new.
No. How much more?
How much more shall the blood of Christ?
The blood of Christ. Now, the covenant. The blood sanctified and by my word, my word is true. It's sanctified by the blood of the Lamb, the blood of Christ, who through the blood,
who through the eternal Spirit offered himself.
That is the Spirit of the Son of God that God says he will tell him to go into your heart. The eternal Spirit is his law. The eternal Spirit is his word. The eternal Spirit is the reminder. He is the Spirit of God. He is the power of God, Christ Jesus. Amen. Get into your conscience and start condemning you to change. Condemnation is acknowledging in the errors that you're committing. He'll start to tell you, don't do that. Make you feel so bad. Go ahead and read. Amen.
How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God?
Who without spot to God? How?
Purge your conscience.
Purge your conscience. Now. He's lying. The lambs and the goats and the bullocks couldn't do that. Over here was a while back ago is because the Spirit of God here was not in them, the man to the bullocks. But Jesus had the Spirit of God in him that would not die. Be
purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the First Testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance.
Are you seeing this? Go ahead.
For where a testament is, there must also of necessity be the death of the testator.
Go ahead.
For a testament is a force after men are dead.
But
otherwise, it is of no strength at all while the testator living.
But
whereupon neither the first testament was dedicated without blood. For when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats.
You see the ceremony? This is the ceremony. He took the what?
The blood of calves and goats
and
with water and scarlet wool.
Are you here to see the ceremony?
And sprinkled both the book and all the people.
That was the ceremonies. That was killed. That was abolished. It was stopped. Read.
Saying, this is the blood of the testament which God hath enjoined unto you.
Go ahead.
both the tabernacle and all the vessels of ministry.
And everything will be covered with blood. Everything will be covered with blood. Go ahead.
And almost all things are by the law purged with blood.
Go ahead.
And without shedding of blood, it's what? No remission.
There's no remission. There ain't no cleansing to it without that blood.
It was therefore necessary
that
the patterns of things in the heavens should be purified with these.
Are you seeing this? I want you to see this. In other words, this is the exact same way that the pattern of things in heaven should be purified too.
But the heavenly things themselves with better sacrifices than these.
Are you seeing? In other words, it won't be no more the sprinkling of the blood and all like that, but there's a better sacrifice that's going to be given. Go ahead and read.
For Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands.
Are you seeing this? I want you to see the Lord revealed this to me. This is the part right here that he said he went into the Holy Ghost, signifying that the Holy of Holies was not yet manifested. Here it is right here. Read.
Which are the figures of the truth, but into heaven itself.
Ooh, there it is right there, the Holy of Holies. But into heaven itself. What did he do? He
now to appear in the presence of God for us.
Are you seeing this?
Amen.
He didn't have to go. He's not a high priest when he comes to a natural altar to go to the Holy of Holies. Now, the Holy of Holies was not yet signified. It wasn't signified. He didn't signify it yet. He didn't say, okay, now it is gone. The Holy Ghost was saying that he wasn't established yet because the old had to get out of the way in order for the new to be presented. Now, Christ came not to stand before man, not to stand before the ordinances of the law, but Christ came into literal front of the Father, the Holy of Holies.
For Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands.
See, he didn't go into this part right here. The holy places made with hands. This is all made with hands, man ladies. But there's a holy place that you can't enter until you get in. Are you hearing this? There's a holy place that you can't enter until you die. You gotta die in order to live. Here it is. There's the Holy of Holies. Read.
as the high priest entered into the holy place.
He ain't got a costume. Say, forgive me, Lord, because he ain't made to do that. Go ahead.
Every year with blood of others.
Galatians 4. Hurry up. Hurry up. He will. Galatians 4. Praise the Lord. Galatians 4, we are on your way again. Praise the Lord. Galatians 4, last one. 4-7. Go ahead and read this.
But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth his Son.
He sent forth our Savior.
Made of a woman.
Made of a woman.
Made under the law.
Made under, I want you to hear this now. Hear what he's saying. When he said made under the law, he was talking about the Mosaic law. He was talking about the law of God the Father's Spirit. Christ. Made under the law. Read.
To redeem them that were under the law.
To redeem them. Had he been under the Mosaic law, he wouldn't have the power to redeem us. But he was under the law of the Spirit. Are you seeing this? Go ahead.
That we might receive the adoption of sons.
Ooh. Are you hearing this? The verse of that.
And because ye are sons,
and because you are sons,
God has sent forth the Spirit of his Son.
God sent forth the Spirit of his Son into your hearts. Go ahead.
Crying, Abba, Father. Wherefore thou art no more a servant, but a son.
But a son.
And if a son, then an heir of God.
An heir, in other words, you have the promise of the covenant. Because the covenant said, I will never leave you comfortless. The Holy Ghost comes in. Are you hearing this? The Holy Ghost comes in. Go ahead and read.
And if a son, then an heir of God.
And we are Christ. God. Through who?
Christ.
In other words, we are grafted into this adoption. There was paper signed with your name on it. God said, we're going to make you free from bondage. January 1st, I want you to hear.
Be ready.